On a modern map, the city of Tyre has changed dramatically from that of its ancient counterpart. Ancient Tyre existed in two parts, a mainland city and an island city. Accordingly, it was a center for maritime trade. In fact, the name for the coastal territory that encompasses Tyre was given to it by the Greeks, Phoenicia, meaning purple. A specialized purple dye was extracted from murex shells fished from the Mediterranean and then shipped out of Tyre. It was a rich, important city. The relationship between Israel and Tyre seems to have begun with the friendship between Tyre's King Hiram and King David. Hiram shipped lumber to Joppa first for David's palace and later for the Jerusalem temple. As with all alliances, they can fail, though, and by the end of the monarchy period, the prophet Ezekiel records a few prophecies of destruction against Tyre. Ezekiel 26 begins with a general prophecy that says, "God will bring many nations against you, like the sea casting up its waves. They will destroy the walls of Tyre and pull down her towers. I will scrape away her rubble and make her a bare rock. Out in the sea she will become a place to spread fish nets, for I have spoken, declares the Lord." This prophecy uses the image of waves of destruction brought by multiple enemy nations. Looking at Tyre's history, it's clear that this did happen. First wave was Nebuchadnezzar, the ruling king of Babylon in Ezekiel's time and mentioned by name in the Bible. Nebuchadnezzar besieged mainland Tyre for 13 years, eventually conquering it and taking its king captive. The details of Tyre's defeat here or surrender aren't known, but the island city remained proudly undefeated. The next wave of Tyre's destruction came at the hands of Alexander the Great. Snubbed by the island city, Alexander commanded his army to scrape and throw all of the rubble and rocks of mainland Tyre into the sea, building a thin, long causeway out to the city. There, he breached its wall and took the prize. Alexander evidently used all of the rocks and timber of old Tyre to build his war bridge, because none of it has been found in place. In fact, the buildup of silt over the centuries has created an artificial landmass connecting the old island city to the mainland. Despite this thorough thrashing unleashed by Alexander, the city was rebuilt, eventually becoming a prominent Roman city and incorporating its new peninsula. Tyre's final death blow came in AD 1291. After several takeovers, it was finally captured by the Mamluk Muslims and burned to the ground, never to be rebuilt again. Thanks for watching. Click the playlist on screen now to watch more spotlights. And if you want to read the full article, click the link in the description. You can always go to BibleDiscoveryTV.com for more videos, articles, and resources.